is the Orange Crush 20. One of the smallest, biggest sounding amps in the world. Orange are known for their lovely, thick, almost wall of saturation. And this managed to do it with it only being 20 watts and having an 8-inch speaker. Obviously, I'm doing this video as part of the 6 best beginner metal amps, so I'll be playing a lot of metal. But these guys are huge in the metal scene. Who uses Orange amps these days? Obviously, Jim Root, he's a big guy. He's a pretty big guy as well. Brent Hines, you can class Mastodon as metal. That's pretty metal. Who else? Mine's gone back again. Who's your favorite Orange metal artist? Comment down below and let me know. Anyways, more specs on this little bad guy. It has 2 channels. It's very, very simply laid out. Channel 1 has a volume. Channel 2 has a gain and a volume. They both share a 3-band EQ. There is an auxiliary in, so you can play along with your favorite backing tracks. Plug your phone in, plug your iPad in, plug your Walkman in, or whatever you've got, and jam along with that. There's also an emulated headphone line out with cab simulation in it, so you can listen to your headphones and not wake up your parents and still jam along to your lovely orangey metal goodness. And it's as simple as that, really. The 2 channels are foot switchable with an optional FS1, I believe it's called, Orange footswitch, which is almost the size of this thing. It's very light, it's very loud. The gain control has 4 preamp stages, 4 gain stages, so it gets hairier and hairier as you go up, but kind of has new characteristics with every little stage. Let's play with that now. So it really starts to break up around about 4 on the gain control. All the EQ controls are set at noon, by the way. I should mention that. Let's go up to halfway. Notice how the characteristics change there, going from halfway to 3/4. Can you hear that when it enters the new gain stage? Such a lovely, thick, fluffy sound. It's fantastic. But what I do say with Orange amps, even their solid state ones, is when you play a chord, you can hear every single note within that chord, even though it's such a big, fluffy wall of saturation. They're very dynamic little things for how crazy they are. Now let's dime the gain, because I can, and that's what it sounds like. Play with the EQ controls there. Everything's at 1 o'clock. Let's do the metal thing now. Put the gain around about 1 o'clock. Crank the bass, crank the treble, and take the mid out. And this is how that sounds. It's very, very hairy, man, and these oranges are very, very unique sounding. Some people do enjoy putting overdrives in front of orange amps as well to kind of tighten everything up a little bit. I mean, before the oranges of today, the oranges of yesteryear were very, very fluffy. Now they've managed to tighten them right up for you metal players, and you can do that with this, with a tube screamer. It's awesome.